guys, here it is, the 2005 F4 Tamburini. Getting ready to go for a first ride. Wanted to do a quick video just to kind of point out some of the cool things about the bike. Always guess I get asked around, like, what are the difference between all the different F4s that I have? So here's the Tamburini. Cool facts about this particular bike. Most of you guys probably know, but this particular bike was designed to pay tribute to Massimo Tamburini, one of the greatest, probably if not the greatest, bike designer. He designed the Ducati 916, the MV Agusta F4s, and many, many other bikes, Bimotos, and on and on. So here are some of the cool facts about the bike. First, carbon fiber and fairing, front fairing, side fairing, and the tail. Gas tank is not like the Oro, obviously the front fender and rear fender as well. But here's the cool part about the fairing and the paint job. It's actually exposed carbon, if you guys can see, for the most part. And then obviously has the paint on it to show it. Same thing with the CRC sign, F4s, the carbon shows throughout. Also has the carbon air intakes. I can show you the tail as well. You can see the carbon showing throughout on there, which is pretty cool. The wheels are not magnesium. They're forged alloy wheels that are yellow, which pretty cool design if you ask me. Fits amazing on this particular bike. Another cool part is the swing arm. Swing arm is actually magnesium, but it's not yellow. So most people don't actually think it's magnesium, but it is. This particular bike is 173 horsepower, if I recall correctly. Weight's about 410 pounds. Top speed is rated at about 190 miles. So this thing would definitely go. And another cool fact, I don't know if you guys, many of you know, check this out. The little plaque on the bike, this one is actually number, let me see if I can focus. This is number 85 out of 300. This particular little plaque is actually 18 karat gold. Very interesting. I didn't know that until recently. Read about it and was like, oh, it's pretty cool. You know, throw some gold on the bike, makes it look cooler. Bike is pretty much all stock for the most part. The only thing that's not stock at the moment is the exhaust, or it's actually, it is stock, but not off the right bike. This exhaust, the slash cut is from the 312. 1078R bike. I do have the stock exhaust as well. Check out the rear sets, F4 1000. You know, the touches on this particular bike are very interesting. When Massimo Tamburini designed the bikes, one of his dreams was like he wanted to design one of the best looking bikes and at the same time be functional, obviously. Fastest bike, most powerful bike. So this bike at 2005 was obviously way, way ahead of its time, being of what it is. It's pretty much considered to be, you know, as most of the MVs, a lot of people say it's like art on wheels. It's the best way to describe what MV Agusta is. So let's get ready and we'll go out on a quick ride, hear it and see how it rides. Stay tuned.
Let's go. Hopefully we don't run out of gas, doesn't have much. Definitely sounds nice, can't go wrong with that. Planning a long ride and it looks like we're low on gas anyway, so that limits us even further, but should be enough just to kind of experience the bike. Very smooth first gear. Oh yeah. Thing will move. I mean, just the sound that this bike makes is absolutely amazing. I tell people, you know, once you start getting into like the higher RPMs, it's comparable to like the old Formula One cars. And it's so fast. I mean, it just gets there so quickly. The response from the throttle is absolutely instant, even in the low RPMs. I mean, some of these bikes, some of the F4s struggle in the low RPMs, but this bike is so smooth. Feels very light actually, which is a bit surprising compared to some of my previous F4s or some of the other F4s that I've ridden. They're not the lightest bikes, but this one actually feels pretty light. That obviously helps with the handling, you know. It's got to do with the obvious suspension setup and things like that. So definitely looking forward to riding this bike here. Brakes feel good. Really good actually. Very grabby. I like it. horsepower, it's plenty of power for most riders. I mean, nowadays bikes obviously are in the 200s, but this was 2005. Again, it's almost 20 years ago that this bike was designed. I just love how it sounds, absolutely amazing. And this, guys, pretty much concludes our first ride, limited due to being low on gas. So that's it. Let me know, for those of you guys that have the same bike, what your experience is. Currently 5,800 miles. Stay tuned, we're gonna put some more miles on it in the future.
So first ride was success. We were a little bit low on fuel, so I didn't want to go too far around the neighborhood, but got it into, you know, third, fourth gear. I mean, what a bike. The power delivery is absolutely instant. Plenty of power, 172 horsepower, you know, really for daily riding, I think it's more than enough. Bike is plenty fast. Feels very light, which is pretty cool. You know, some of the MVs, especially like the older ones, are a little bit on the heavy side. Like I said, this bike is about 400 pounds compared to like nowadays bikes are much, much lighter, obviously. But, you know, this bike was designed almost 20 years ago. It's 2005. So I would say even compared to like new bikes, it feels very, very fast. With this bike, once you get into the higher RPMs, the bike just, it just takes off even more. So very impressed with it. More than happy that I got it, added into my collection. Looking forward to putting more miles on it. This one's gonna be a rider. Like I said, currently has about 5,000 miles. So looking forward to putting more miles on it and taking it some more bike shows. So stay tuned and look out for it. See you guys. Gonna make a couple more videos about the other bikes. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the button, you know, support the channel. That way we can make more videos about MVs and Ducatis. See you guys later.